Guys, how's it going? Welcome back to FizzVizz. I'm Manas Sharma, and in this tutorial I'll be showing you guys how to create a graphene monolayer using VESTA. And as an example, here you can see a 5x5 supercell of the graphene monolayer visualized in VESTA, and by the end of this tutorial you'll be able to do so as well. So first of all, a graphene monolayer is nothing but one of the layers of the graphite allotrope of carbon. So first of all, we need the CIF file, that is the structural information file for the graphite, and you can get that from this URL, that is from the materials project database. Its ID is MP48, and here in the description you can see that it is graphite and it crystallizes in the hexagonal unit cell and so on, and some more information about it over here. And this is the visualization of the structure. So as you can see, it is a layered material, so it is a van der Waals material where the layers are interacting with via the van der Waals forces or van der Waals interactions. And now what you need to do is you need to export it. So export it as a CIF file. And by the way, if you have not logged into this database, then maybe you may need to log in to download this file. But here in my case, I'm already logged in, so I would download it straight away. If this icon isn't visible for you, then please try logging in. Anyway, so here is the CIF file that has been downloaded. Now let's go ahead and open it in VESTA. So here is the visualization in VESTA. Now before we move further, I want to clear up one thing. So in my previous videos also, I received a lot of comments or questions about this, where a lot of you had this confusion about the number of atoms that you're simulating and the number of atoms you're viewing in this VESTA visualization. So let me clear this up for you. So first of all, the number of atoms that you see in a visualizer is not a clear indicator of the number of atoms that you're actually simulating. So just because you're seeing, I don't know, like 24 atoms here, does not mean that you're actually simulating 24 atoms, because whenever you are doing calculations with something like quantum espresso, bars, or turbomol, then you also have periodic boundary conditions built in. So of course you are not going to specify any atom that lies outside the cell. So here of course you can see so many atoms being visualized outside the cell or beyond the boundary of the unit cell. So in order to although I have created a video on understanding the crystallographic information file format a while back, so you can check that out in the link. The link to it is in the description down below, but still, okay, let me take this moment to clear some confusion up regarding this. So if you open the CIF file, what you will see is that it only has information for 4 atoms. And then it has some symmetry operations. So it is saying that it is providing only one symmetry operation, that is the identity operation. So essentially what that means is there are 4 unique or non-equivalent atoms at least for this particular graphene unit cell. Now the number of atoms being displayed in a visualizer is going to be different depending on the visualizer, how it handles it. So for example, in VESTA, here again, when I imported it, you can see that it says that it has read 4 atoms from the CIF file, but it has then decided to display 24 atoms by, you know, considering those symmetries and adding additional atoms. Similarly, on materials project database, it decided to display, I don't know, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 2, 10 atoms. So depending on the visualizer, so essentially the CIF file only contains 2 atoms per layer, because for example these atoms at the corners that you are seeing, they are being equally shared by 4 adjacent unit cells. So essentially, even one, if you only just specify, because in VASP or quantum espresso you cannot say, okay, this atom is being shared by 4 unit cell, so give it a partial occupancy of 0.25. no, you cannot do that. You have to specify, okay, this atom is there, and then the repeat or the periodic image of this atom will be constructed or taken care of by the software itself. So essentially you only provide the coordinates of one atom at the corner and one atom inside the unit cell. So in the top layer, the CIF file contains the coordinates of these 2 atoms, and the bottom layer probably contains the coordinates of these 2 atoms. I mean, the corner atom could be either of these 4, But yeah, one of the atoms that is inside, of course, it is not being shared by any other unit cell, so that has to be there. So therefore, the CIF file or the structure that you will simulate will only have four atoms. And for example, there is this another visualizer called JMOL. Now let's see what it visualizes if I import this file that I downloaded. So here you can see that it does not actually repeat any atoms. It basically visualizes whatever it sees in the crystallographic information file and visualizes that. Therefore, it only visualizes four atoms. Now in my previous video, I showed you guys how to remove this confusion by getting rid of all these extra atoms that VESTA is visualizing. And the trick to do that was to go to Edit, then go to Bonds, and then click here, and then select to not search atoms beyond the boundary, and hit OK. And now you can see that the visualization is similar to the one you see on the materials project database. So yeah, so here it is now very similar to that. However, in order to make it similar to JMOL, because otherwise I can understand, as a beginner, it's hard to understand, like, why are you seeing so many atoms here, but when you're simulating, you only have four atoms there. So yeah, I can understand your like inconvenience. So next you need to go to Objects, go to Boundary, and then select the X max to be a value like 0.99, so just slightly smaller than one, not exactly one. So yeah, so 0.99 for X max, Y max, Z max, and hit OK. And voila, here you now have a visualization that conforms to a structure that you're going to simulate rather than what you just visualize. So when you visualize, you see all these spurious artificial atoms being there. And indeed, now you can see that VESTA is also saying that it is now visualizing just four atoms. Okay, so enough about how to handle all these, or like understanding these crystallographic information files and the visualization differences. But yeah, okay, I hope I have tried. I hope I have succeeded in clearing up this doubt or confusion among the beginners. So coming back to the motive of this tutorial, that is to create a graphene monolayer. So first of all, of course, we need to get rid of one of the layers. So either you can do that by selecting this atom and pressing delete, for example, selecting this, pressing delete, or what you can do alternatively is to, alternatively what you can do is you can go to Edit, go to Edit Data, go to Units, go to Structure Parameters, in fact, and then get rid of the atoms that lie on the same vertical plane, or like the XY plane, sorry, my bad. So yeah, so 0.75 Z value corresponds to the two atoms that lie on the same plane. So just go ahead and delete those and hit OK. So here is your graphene monolayer's smallest possible unit cell with just two atoms. However, an additional thing that you need to care about is the vacuum. So in programs such as VASP or Quantum Espresso, where periodic boundary conditions are built in along all the directions, you will have these atoms being repeated after a certain Z value. So for example, here, if I go to summary, I can see that the C lattice vector that is along the Z axis is just 7.8 angstroms. So it will repeat this graphene monolayer will repeat after 7.8 angstroms. And that will mean that there will be some weather walls interactions between the two layers at that distance. So what you want is you want to remove this spurious interaction between the layers, because you're simulating a monolayer, not a layered material. So in order to do that, you need to increase the vacuum in your system. And you can do that by going to Edit and then going to Unit Cell and then clicking over here in the C vector. And let's say increase it to like something like 15 angstroms, I guess, and hit OK. So 15 angstroms is something that is usually enough to prevent these layers or atoms, these periodic images of these atoms from interacting with each other. So yeah, so right now what you have managed is you have managed to create the smallest possible unit cell for graphene monolayer, and you can simulate it and get all the properties of graphene. However, if you want to create a supercell for it now the way that you can do that is you can go to Edit, you can go to Edit Data, you can go to Unit Cell, then you will go to Transform, and now you can enter the size of the unit supercell that you want to create. So let's say I want to create a 5x5 supercell. I type that in. So this corresponds to the repetition in the x-axis, this corresponds to the repetition in y-axis, this corresponds to the repetition in z-axis. So now we'll hit enter, click on yes, click on search atoms in the new unit cell and add them as new sites. Hit on OK, then OK again, and voila, here is your 5x5 graphene monolayer supercell. Now you can place water molecule on it or any other molecule on it and do some adsorption studies. I've created several videos on how to add a molecule on top of the graphene surface as well, so you can check them out. They will be in the description down below. But yeah, so right now we have managed to create this supercell, and now finally we need to just export it for our calculations. So let's say I want to perform a VASP calculation after it, so I will click on export data, then I will select the save as type to be VASP. Here I can type in graphene monolayer 5x5 as the name and click on save. Next, usually I prefer Cartesian coordinates, so I will select that. And in the drop down menu, you can select output current unit cell and hit on OK. And now if I go to my downloads directory, I can basically go ahead and open this file in my text editor just to verify. Yeah, that is again very important. You need to verify if the number of atoms that you exported from VESTA are correct or not. So it is saying that it has 50 C atoms, should it? So the unit cell had 2 C atoms, and then I created a 5x5 supercell, that is 5 times 5 equals 25, and 25 times 2 C atoms will be 50 C atoms, and that is indeed what I have here. And we can even visualize it in VESTA. So here is the visualization. Again, you are seeing those additional spurious atoms outside the boundary and beyond the boundary. But the good thing is you can see that it read the information for 50 atoms, so that is correct. However, it then decided to visualize 84 atoms, but that is only a visualization artifact, only a visualization issue. It's not going to be affecting your simulations because the POSCAR that we just generated only has 50 atoms. Similarly, you can also export it to some other format, let's say as a CIF file, and yeah, hit on save, and you can again, you know, go ahead and open this CIF file that we just generated in your text editor, and you can see all the parameters, and you can also see that it has again 50 carbon atoms as expected. So yeah, so that is basically it for this tutorial. I hope I have succeeded in giving you an idea about the differences in what you are simulating and what you are visualizing with these programs. And also I hope I succeeded in telling you how to create a graphene monolayer and its supercell using VESTA. In case you guys found this tutorial useful, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.